I have to say that, you know, it is such a pleasure to be here this afternoon because I have read a lot about, you know, El Sistema, and I've heard a lot about these orchestras, but it just seemed too good to be true. And so it was great to see today that actually it is true. I'm very interested in this because I also heard that refugee children are allowed to participate in the orchestra. And I think this is such a wonderful opportunity to give to the refugee children as well. And I know that just listening and seeing the faces here, I can just see the very wonderful effect this program can have, not only musically, but more importantly, you know, the social impact that it has on the children. And as I watch the children play, I just think of, you know, the many people that you have picked up from the street and keep away from the street to do these very enjoyable activities. And it says everything in the faces of the parents, in the faces of the children. And I feel such a lot of passion also in the people who are involved in running this nucleus. So I must say that I'm very impressed, and I'm so happy to have the opportunity to come and see for myself. Not only just to read about El Sistema, but to see how it really works. I think everybody would like to see something work, you know, in their own country as well. And I'm trying to understand what is it that makes it work here. That's why I want to try and understand a little bit, you know, from Petro here. How do you make it work so well, you know, because and that this has lasted for 40 years. I think to make something like that sustainable is really quite an achievement. I hope that it can be replicated in many other parts of the world, because I think there is such a need today for young people, you know, through education, through activities like this, you know, to give them an alternative to things that they otherwise would get involved in. You know, the negative things, and you know there are a lot of dangers and pressures, you know, in our society today, and I think this is such a good alternative for them. Well, I think for the children, I think, you know, the fact that they themselves come here and that this is something that they get involved in out of their own passion, and this is what is important. You know, there's no one forcing them. I have seen, for example, sometimes, you know, children says, well, they have to go to school or they have to go for music lessons, and the parents have to force them to go. But here is a very different story. You know, in many, sometimes I see in some family where the parents are well off and they want to give music lesson to the children, the children are very reluctant. But here, it's motivated. I see a very strong sense of motivation from the children and from the parents. So I would like to understand better, what is the secret? Particularly in the refugee situation, okay. You know, the refugee children are in very difficult situation, and they come from, you know, they have faced a lot of traumas just by being refugees. Sometimes, you know, it's very difficult to see hope for the future, but when they can get engaged in activities like that, I think it gives them such a sense of dignity and, you know, an achievement. And I think that it would help the refugee break out of their vicious cycle of, you know, being in this, to be a refugee is very difficult. I think this gives them an alternative to move beyond being a refugee.